Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, distinguished speakers and guests, President Carmencita Romanash, fellow board of director members, members of the board of trustees, fellow historic committee members, Peruvian brothers and sisters, family and friends, I would like at this time to welcome you to OPPG's Historic Committee Conference entitled Operation Pedro Pan, a 50-year perspective. I am honored with this lifetime opportunity to have all under one roof the representatives of the three most instrumental forces in the creation of Operation Pedro Pan, namely the Catholic Church of Miami, Monsignor Brian O. Walsh, and James Baker. We also have academics that have dedicated their lives to researching and documenting the history of our native Cuba, including the chapter on the history of Operation Pedro Pan. In addition, we have academics that have made us so proud with the success of their books, and that through those books, they have made our history better known throughout the world. We also have individuals that know what it was like to live through what we Pedro Pans were spared by our parents. We also have individuals that are Pedro Pans of first and second generation, as well as professors, students, members of the press, family and friends. I am thrilled with your presence. Operation Pedro Pan did not happen in one day. It took place during a 22-month span, specifically from December of 1960 to October of 1962. And the timing of this conference, which falls at the midpoint of the trajectory of the operation's 50th anniversary, that is, 11 months from the beginning of December of last year and 11 months from the conclusion on October of next, is the perfect time to look to the past in order to gain a perspective of the present so that we can look towards the future to see how we can apply the lessons learned in this 50-year experience. Given the historical significance of this anniversary period, the Historic Committee was implemented last year so that the critical task of collecting, preserving, and disseminating our information on our past for posterity could be more effectively achieved. One part of the threefold mission statement of our organization promises to document our history for future generations and to spread the knowledge of our exodus as an important chapter of the history of Cuba and of the United States. And the bylaws of our organization state that the chairperson of the Historic Committee be particularly vigilant as to the true and correct history of Operation Pedro Pan. For the past year, I have been working very hard to do just that. And this conference is our first major event. But thanks to the support of our committee members, we have been able to accomplish a number of objectives. An application for a Florida historical marker for the Florida City Camp was submitted to the State's Bureau of Historic Preservation in January of 2011. It was approved by the State's Historical Marker Council in August, and at the suggestion of the Council, we will be preparing the applications of the other camps and documenting our intangible history at state and national levels. Tomorrow's Miami Conversacion, as well as other workshops and related activities are planned, and volunteers will be needed. State Florida Marker Council member Jorge Hernandez will be here later today to expand on this subject. The preparation of the Florida City Camp Florida Historical Marker application was a two-year collaboration among team members Jose Antonio Amaro Reyes, Susana Garrandez Rodriguez, and myself. Unfortunately, Jose Antonio cannot be here due to health issues, but I would like to take this opportunity to thank him for his contribution to the Historic Committee. The creation of a Facebook profile is allowing us to post Pedro Pan past and present and recent news and publicize Pedro Pan related activities locally and in other regions of the country. Apart from sharing this information with a global Pedro Pan community, we are reaching people all over the world, including people residing in Canada, Australia, the United Kingdom, Italy, Serbia, Holland, Japan, Spain, Argentina, and Brazil, to name a few. One of its key objectives has been to educate readers by disseminating information either by posting it or by providing links that users can employ to access it online. By the same token, journalists from countries as far removed as Argentina and Norway, to name a few, and students are all academic levels throughout the United States and graduate degree students from faraway countries such as Poland and Ireland are consulting it with the purpose of gathering information for their graduate work. Moreover, the creation of the Facebook account, once employed as a supplement and in conjunction with the resources section of OPPG's website, serves the objective of reaching a broader international audience. We developed a PowerPoint presentation entitled The History of Operation Pedro Pan. It has been presented at Barry University, Florida International University, the Office of Homeland Security, the Holocaust Museum of Southeast Florida, Miami-Dade College campuses, the Department of Health and Human Services, Office of Medicare Hearings and Appeals, different schools, colleges, universities, book clubs, and other venues in different regions of the country. It was on continuous play at the Green Library FIU through the month of August and September, and it has been posted on YouTube channel Boron 10, as well as on the Facebook accounts of California Kids of the 60s Exodus and on OPPGs. We have developed questionnaires that are used to conduct film interviews with Pedro Pan parents and caretakers. Such interviews are already underway. Next, as soon as the parent and caretaker phase is completed, we will proceed with interviews of the former Pedro Pan children themselves. In October, Miami-Dade County Schools added Operation Pedro Pan to its Hispanic Heritage Month curriculum, and OPPG has agreed to sponsor essay contests for students at different school levels. Dr. Robert Blasovsky, Social Science Curriculum Supervisor for Miami-Dade County Public Schools, who authored the instructional packet, is here and will explain this effort in more detail later today. This conference is a culmination of the year's projects, and here we will analyze our exodus in three stages. In the historical context stage, we will review the historical sequence of events that led to our parents' decision to send their children to safety. In the retrospective evaluation stage, we will take and compare a look at the alternatives faced by all Cuban children once the revolution chose to replace the existing pre-revolution youth culture with its mandated Hombre Nuevo experiment. In the prospective view stage, we will examine ways to apply the lessons learned, books and books. We'll have some of the books authored by the speakers available for purchase, and there will be ample time allotted for book signing, and there will also be guayaberas and t-shirts and many things that are available for purchase. I would like to thank our sponsors for their generous contributions, and I would also like to thank all of you for your support. Your participation in all our events is essential to the success of all of our activities. These activities, in turn, are essential to the task of documenting and disseminating our history. I think that you will agree with me when I say that there is no better way to honor the sacrifice of our parents and the numerous heroes, both known and unknown, that helped us in our moment of need than by making sure that our history survives us the way that we lived it, the way that it actually happened, the way that only we can witness it. We owe them that much. I hope that you enjoy the program that we have prepared with such an impressive roster of distinguished speakers. Once again, I thank you for your support, and I look forward to sharing with all of you this conference and all the other events throughout the weekend. Thank you. I now have the great honor of introducing someone that came to the United States through Operation Pedro Pan. Although we never met then, we must have crossed each other's path in the crowded hallways of Miami Senior High many times. Although he was never able to reunite with his parents, he did not allow the sacrifice to be in vain. Instead, he took advantage of the opportunities afforded him by their selfless and heart-wrenching sacrifice. Today, he holds a PhD in International Affairs from the University of Miami. He was one of the founders of Pediatrics Medical Group, the nation's leading provider of pediatric specialty service. He co-founded Children's Center for Development Behavior. He was an adjunct professor of international business at the School of Business Administration's Department of Management at the University of Miami. He is a senior research associate at the University of Miami's Institute for Cuban and Cuban American Studies and is the author of Mañana in Cuba. He is a trustee of Operation Pedro Pan and also a member of OPPG's Historic Committee. Please welcome Dr. Jose Acel.